Today we're taking a look at Sucrose Wallpaper Engine, which is another free and open source utility that you can use to customize your desktop background, and you can use it to set animated, interactive, and videos as wallpapers on your Windows PC. Now, in one of my previous videos, I covered Lively Wallpaper, and Sucrose Wallpaper Engine basically does the same thing, but it also has some other settings and features that's not found in Lively Wallpaper, and that's what I want to show you in this video. So to get Sucrose Wallpaper Engine, you can just download it from this Microsoft Store downloads page or via the Microsoft Store itself. I'm just going to download it from the downloads page, and then I'll just go through the normal installation process. Now, once Sucrose Wallpaper is installed and you launch it on your computer, this is the screen that you'll be seeing. And on the first tab here, which is the library tab, you have a few options for preset wallpapers that come with Sucrose Wallpaper Engine. So some of these wallpapers do look familiar, as they're also included with Lively Wallpaper. For example, in the previous video, I used this rainy wallpaper, and it looks like I ran into the same bug as I did in the previous recording, where I actually selected a wallpaper, but it's not applied. So how I fixed that in the previous recording is I right-clicked on the desktop, went to View, and then toggled the Show Desktop Icons setting. And as you can see, as soon as I toggled that setting, the wallpaper is now showing. And now it doesn't matter which setting I have, I just had to toggle that setting for it to work. So remember to do that if you run into the same bug. But as you can see here on the homepage, you have a few options that you can choose from that are preset wallpapers. If I choose the floating in space wallpaper, it'll change to that. And now I've got this astronaut swimming in space, I guess. Then it's also got the fluid simulation. If I toggle to that, you'll see this is an interactive wallpaper. So as I move the mouse, the wallpaper reacts to it. And I'm sorry for flashbanging you with this wallpaper. Now, before we get to the thing that sets Sucrose Wallpaper Engine apart from Lively Wallpaper, for those of you who's never used Sucrose Wallpaper Engine or Lively Wallpaper before, let me just show you how to add a custom wallpaper or a video as a wallpaper. So here in the UI at the top right, you'll see a Create Wallpaper button, a plus sign. If you click on that, then you can create your own theme as a GIF, or you can use a URL, a web theme, a video theme, a YouTube theme, or an application theme. So for example, if we wanted to use a YouTube video as our desktop background, we can select the YouTube theme. You can select any video, copy the URL of that video, then go back to Sucrose Wallpaper Engine. Then I'll just paste that URL. Then next you have to enter a title. So I'll just call it The Drive, which is the title of the YouTube video. For the description, I'll also title it The Drive. And then the other fields you don't have to fill out, you can just leave those. And then you can click on Create. And what that's going to do is it's going to set that video from YouTube that you just selected as your desktop background. And it took a while to load to a better resolution, but as you can see, now I have that YouTube video as a desktop background. So once again, if you come over to the Add Theme button to create a wallpaper, you've got a few different options here, and you can use whichever one you like. One of the other popular ones is using a video theme, where you basically choose a video file that's saved on your computer and then set that as your desktop background. But I've covered most of this in the previous video as well about Lively Wallpaper, and since these two apps basically work the same way, I'm not going to go over those things in depth again. I do want to get to the thing that, in my opinion, sets Sucrose Wallpaper Engine apart from Lively Wallpaper, and that is the fact that you can go to the store and that you can search for wallpapers that's made by other creators. So I've just selected the store tab, and you can see there's a bunch of categories here that we can go through to choose wallpapers and discover new animated wallpapers. But before we dive into this, I want to go to the settings first, because if you go to the settings and you go to the personal tab, you'll find this option here that says unsafe content and whether to display content marked as not safe for work in the store. And this is enabled by default. So I'm going to disable this, and I suggest that you guys do the same, because we don't want to see unsafe content, hey? So if we go back and we go to the store, as I mentioned, there's a bunch of different categories here, and I'm not going to go through all of them in this video. The point is to show you that inside of Sucrose Wallpaper Engine, it's much easier to discover new animated wallpapers than it is compared to Lively Wallpaper at the time of this recording. So I'm just going to choose one of these categories, like architecture and buildings. We've got one wallpaper here, so I'll just click on that to download it. And there you go. Now we have that wallpaper that was found in the store. set as my desktop wallpaper. If I do a search for a wallpaper, what if I put the term calm? I'll just select this paradise wallpaper. And now we've got this calm paradise wallpaper set as the desktop background. So I think you get the idea. You can browse the store for whatever wallpaper you'd like. And there's a ton of options to choose from. Now, if we move on to some of the other icons here in the UI, we've got this wallpaper cycling icon. So you have the option to choose whether the wallpaper changes automatically or not. Then you can set a time interval, the transition mode, and then you can also reset the cycle list to default. So if we close that and we go to the next icon, which is the display preferences, you can see I have two monitors. If you have more than two, all of your monitors will show up here. And then you can see we do have a placement mode option. So we have the option to apply the wallpaper to the selected screen only, which in this case would be my primary monitor, or we can expand it across screens, which means it's going to show on all monitors. And you can see as I've selected that, it looks like it's been cut off in my main monitor. So that setting might not work properly at the time of this recording. So I'll just set it back to the selected screen only. And then we also have duplicate the same wallpaper, which for me is grayed out. I can't select that. So in my testing, at least, it looks like there needs to be some work done on the display preferences side of this application, as not all options are available and the expand across screens one is not working properly for me. But regardless, if we go over to the settings, I want to go through some of these settings with you. And some of the settings I want to draw your attention to is the following. You can choose if you want Sucrose Wallpaper Engine to start up when your computer starts up and whether you want to show the notification area icon. And then one of the very important things with these wallpaper apps is the engine volume. So some of these wallpapers do have sound, or the videos have sound that you set as wallpapers, and you'll hear that sound constantly on your PC. So those sounds can become quite distracting when you're trying to do something else like watch videos or whatever. So what I recommend is just turning the sound all the way down so that you don't hear any sound coming from those video wallpapers. Then in the performance tab, you have a pause rule option. So this determines the rule for pausing your wallpapers based on your performance settings. So here you have two options, either heavy or light. And I have to be honest, I don't know quite exactly what these two mean. I'm guessing we'll have to look at the documents for that. But regardless, you do have an option to pause the wallpaper. But if we look at more of these settings, we do have a system resources section. So here you can actually choose what happens to the wallpaper based on the processor usage, graphics usage, memory usage, and network usage. So here we have the options to either resume the wallpaper, pause it, or close it completely. And next to that, we also have this expand icon where you can choose when this setting is applied. So if we expand all of these, you can see that you can set your processor usage, the graphics usage, then you can also set the memory usage, and you have network usage settings that you have really granular control over to make the application do exactly what you want depending on how your hardware is performing. Then you also have some operating system options with regards to what happens to the wallpaper when your computer is locked, when you put it to sleep mode, when a user is switched, when you log out, or when a screensaver starts. And you basically have the same options: close, pause, or resume. And then you also have laptop battery power, what happens to the wallpaper when you're running on battery power and battery saver. And then some other general system entries like virtualization, remote desktop, full screen mode, or focus mode. So what happens to the wallpaper when any application is running in full screen mode? If you play games and you play those games in full screen mode, then you can set the full screen mode to close or pause so it doesn't use any resources while you're gaming. And you can basically do that for full screen mode and focus mode. So although I said I don't know exactly what this pause rule means for pausing the wallpaper based on your performance settings, with Sucrose Wallpaper Engine, you do have really granular control over exactly what happens to the wallpaper based on what is happening with your computer. If we move over to the wallpaper tab, you have an option to choose the interaction method. So basically, if you have an interactive wallpaper set as your desktop background, you can choose how you want to control it with the mouse and keyboard, the keyboard only, the mouse only, or if you want to close it completely. And then you also have an interaction module with some more settings. And then you have some other general wallpaper settings like your screen layout, the stretch mode, and whether you want to use hardware acceleration for supported wallpapers, You can change the extensions that you use when playing GIFs or videos. And then lastly, you have some options here to choose which engines are used when you get wallpapers from a URL or from YouTube or from the web. And here you can choose between these two options. Now, just to have a look at the resources that Sucrose Wallpaper Engine uses while it's running in the background, you can see it's barely using any CPU at all, not even 1% at the moment. And with regards to the RAM, it's about 120 megs. So it is a little bit more than Lively Wallpaper, which was around 100 megs when I had the wallpaper active. But regardless, that's really not a lot of memory to be using on a modern computer. And I wouldn't say that this application is resource intensive at all. So to sum it all up, I do think Sucrose Wallpaper Engine is a great application when it comes to customizing your desktop background. I know I've compared it a lot to Lively Wallpaper, but it is because it's kind of a Lively Wallpaper clone. Like I said, what I think does set it apart is that the store is actually working so that you can easily discover new wallpapers and set those as your desktop background. And with all of that being said, I really hope this video was of some sort of value to you. If it was, please give the video a like, subscribe to the channel. And as always, I just want to give a shout out to my YouTube members. Thanks so much for your support. I really appreciate it. And I'll talk to all of you guys soon.